Edgenuity is a new platform that some of your teachers may be using, so we just wanted to walk you through the process and show you how to choose today. When you go to the Edgenuity homepage, you can go through and you can pick student login, and you can go ahead and log in. When you log in, your homepage will come up. This is your dashboard, and you will see these different little tiles. The little tiles, there's a unique one for every class in which you're enrolled. A couple things to notice here. If you notice the progress bar on it, if your teacher set a target date, the progress bar will be lit up with how much you have completed. So this student here is 3% complete in this course. It will also tell you if you are ahead or if you are behind. So when you're ready to start your activities, you can go ahead and click anywhere on the tile. And when you click on the tile, it'll bring you to your course map. Your course map, a couple things to notice. First of all, if you have any feedback from your teachers, you'll have a blue pop-up message here. If you just pick view now, and then you can click on any of these thought bubbles, it will take you into that particular lesson. If you click on the thought bubble again, you can go through and you can read your teacher's comments. So you can go through and you can look if you have any feedback. And if you go back to our course map, if we go back to the home screen, a couple other things for you to notice. If you look over here, this first little icon here with the bullet points, that's your course map, which we're viewing now. If you wanted to go through and take some notes, if you click on the pencil, you can pull up your e-notes and you can take any notes that you'd like to for the course. If you pull up the bar graph below, this just shows your progress. It will go through and it will show your overall grade, and it also shows you if you're on target or if you're ahead or if you are behind. Let's go back up to the course map and we'll show you a couple other things here. So in the course map, you can see all the different lessons that you have completed and your different grades and how much time it took you to complete these lessons. And you can see the current lesson you're on. The current lesson you're on is indicated by the little person. All complete lessons will have check marks by them. So the current one you're on will have the little person next to it. The date out front is your target date. So that is basically the due date for your lesson. And when you're ready to go through, you can just click on that activity and it will start for you. Now, I did already start this lesson. I just wanted to show you a couple things to notice here. If you notice at the bottom of the screen, you see these little tiny squares. Any square that's outlined in gray still has to be completed. Any square that's outlined in orange has already been completed. And then any square that is actually colored in an orange is the square that you're currently on. So when you finish one square, you can just go ahead and click the orange arrow and click ahead to the next square. To complete a portion, you must listen to all the instruction and answer any questions that are asked. So in this very, very last part of the activity, they have questions they actually want us to answer. I'm just gonna go through and just match them up here, just guess really quick. You can see that if you have anything incorrect, it'll mark them wrong and it will let you go through and it will let you try again. Okay, we'll go ahead and we'll finish matching them up. You're always going to get two tries. So if you have an incorrect answer, you always get two tries to go through and to try and get it right. So you can see this time we have them all correct. So now, as you notice, as we go through and we finish, you can see now that we did finish the activity, all of the squares are outlined in orange. Okay, and we can see this final one. It's giving you a message that the task is complete. If I go through and if I click the forward arrow, you can see that up in the very bottom of the screen here, it comes up for me to move on to the next activity. So I can go ahead and click that arrow if I want to move on to the next activity. If I'm done for the day or if I want to take a little break, I can just go back and I can just click this home page. So that's basically just a brief overview of how to go through and how to use this. I'm sure if you need any help, you can contact your teacher and they can instruct you further.